The Philippine Senate begins its probe into alleged irregularities in the People's Initiative to amend the 1987 Constitution. Senators have flagged the report make that their effort as unconstitutional amid allegations of signature buying to gather the public support. Some House lawmakers also accused of bankrolling the movement.
Chacha is really a very divisive activity. Nakakalungkot po ay there's a time for everything, no? And na sana kita natin noong nakaraang araw, Madam Chair, naging all out war na, naging hell broke loose, nagkaaway-away na, political bickering. This activity of People's Initiative, or PI, is not only the fight between the Senate and the House of Representatives. Dapat malaman din nila kung ano pa ang implikasyon ng mga ito.
May mga sakit na kapag ginamot at biglang nawala ang sintomas, akala natin wala na. Akala natin magaling na yung tao. Akala natin napuksa na natin ang sakit. Kaya ihihinto natin yung gamot. Hanggang isang araw, lilitaw ulit ang sakit. Isa na siyang mas malakas na karamdaman at bago pa natin maagapan, huli na ang lahat. Karamdamang mabilis na ipakalap na sa pamagitan ng pantatanga sa kapwa, paglulustay ng salapi at pagsisinungaling ng matatakaw na opisyal. Yang sakit na yan ang papatay sa demokrasya. At ang sino man magsabi na walang paki ang Senado sa usaping ito, isa lang ang masasabi ko, walang gamot sa kakapalan ng mukha mo.
House leaders were notably absent from the hearing. The only congressman present during the inquiry, Rodante Marcoleta. And he had a heated exchange with some senators.
But as a member, hindi po nyo may alis sa akin na medyo magdamdam rin ako sapagkat ang patutsada ay patungkol sa House of Representatives, lalong-lalo na po yung Speaker. If this congressional hearing ultimately found that the Speaker is the one who spearheaded this or funded this initiative, I will probably request him to step down.
Tama observation ni Attorney Marcoleta, but that cannot be forced. If the Senate does not want to amend the Constitution through a constituent assembly, the House cannot force it. Ganun lang po yun, as simple as that. So therefore,
no one is forcing, Senator.
Precisely. So there should be no complaint kasi we are two autonomous bodies.
The Senate's probe comes a day after the poll body indefinitely suspended all proceedings related to the People's Initiative. A Philippine lawmaker defends the lower chamber's push to amend the Constitution. Albay Representative Joey Salceda asserts it is the lower house's moral duty to push for targeted change, with the country's economy still lagging behind its regional peers.
Kulelat na tayo sa buong Asia. Talo na tayo ng Cambodia, talo na tayo ng Vietnam, lahat, talo na tayo. Dahil sila, bukas tayo sarado. So ano gagawin namin? It's a moral duty on the part of the House really to push constitutional change on the economic front.
Salceda also says House lawmakers have been pushing for charter change for the longest time, but the Senate refuses to act.
358 times na ho kami kasi nag-propose sa Senate since 1987. Kasi nung right after the, siyempre nakita ka agad yung mga mali dun sa Constitution, obviously, dahil yung ina-aprobahan nila.
The Philippine House of Representatives maintains its unequivocal support for President Marcos amid his growing rift with the Dutertes. House lawmakers adopted a resolution Monday showing the chamber's firm commitment to the Marcos administration. Newly appointed House Deputy Speaker David Suarez hits former President Rodrigo Duterte's tirades against Marcos, which he called disrespectful and baseless.
I think it's totally uncalled for. In the past 2 years, we have seen the performance of President Bongbong Marcos. We have seen how he steered reforms in the agriculture sector, in the infrastructure sector, in our economy, in the delivery of social services. And we have seen his commitment to the Filipino people.
Duterte warned Marcos he may suffer the same fate as his father, the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr., who was ousted in the 1986 People Power Revolution. Duterte also claimed Marcos is a drug addict. Marcos countered by saying Duterte's tirades may be an effect of his fentanyl use. A political analyst warns that Duterte poses a real threat to the Marcos administration. Former presidential advisor for political affairs Ronald Llama says it's now an open warfare between the two political clans following former President Duterte's fresh tirades against his successor.
Sinabi niya yung lahat ng forms ng pagpapabagsak from destabilization to insurrection and uprising to coup d'etat to secession, even a hint of assassination, no? In one speech, ay binato niya lahat ito kay Bongbong Marcos. Eh, definitely, from both sides, this is becoming an existential issue. The Duterte, the possible coming of the ICC, could be a very existential issue sa kanila. Kaya nakasandal sila sa pader. But even for Bongbong Marcos, with all these threats, hindi na siya pwedeng yung usual na ginagawa niya na conflict-averse. He has to make a position. He has to show strength. Or else, lalong may encourage itong mga possible destabilizers.
Llamas adds cracks in the so-called Uniteam coalition emerged right after the 2022 elections. Given the fallout, Llamas believes Vice President Sara Duterte should resign from the Marcos cabinet.
When the Uniteam was formed, nung nanalo sila, ay walang substance yung unity. Eh. Diba? Sinasabi lang nila, unity, siguro yung pinaka-konkreto na, yung 20 pesos na bigas. Pero, no, walang platform, walang vision, walang principles. I'm not even sure kung merong friendship yung mga nagsama-sama. If she has an ounce of self-respect, kusa na siya mag-resign. Yung kanyang paliwanag na hindi naman niya kinausap yung kanyang brother, eh medyo almost nakakatawa. Dahil malinaw naman that the lines have been drawn.
Well, turning now to President Marcos' state visit to Vietnam, the two countries have signed deals aimed at strengthening cooperation. Our very own Katrina Domingo now joins us from Hanoi in Vietnam with an update. Kat, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. The Philippines and Vietnam has just finished exchanging a memorandum of agreement on incident prevention and management in the South China Sea just a few hours ago at Vietnam's presidential palace. As you see, Carmina, as we all know, the Philippines and Vietnam both claim parts of this resource-rich Spratly Islands, while China, on the other hand, claims nearly the entire South China Sea. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. said during his bilateral meeting with his Vietnamese counterpart Vo Van Ching that maritime cooperation is the foundation of the strategic partnership between the Philippines and Vietnam, and that the bilateral relations of both countries have spanned in various areas of cooperation. The president underscores that while the two countries continue to face new challenges, they are also presented with a vast number of opportunities for cooperation. He adds that he also expresses his gratitude and appreciation for the mutual high-level arrangements or engagements that have been taking place between Vietnam and the Philippines, and that he recognizes that these visits are a testament to the thriving nature of our relations. So far, Carmina, we are still waiting for the Department of Foreign Affairs and Malacanang to release a copy of that recently signed document between the Philippines and Vietnam so that we can see the new mechanisms that were set in place to ensure that there will be greater cooperation between the two countries. You see, in 2015, the Philippines and Vietnam have already signed their strategic partnership agreement, which guarantees that the two countries will honor the freedom of navigation and overflight in the South China Sea. That 2015 agreement has also established a hotline between of Vietnam and the Philippines, and that and it also guarantees that the two countries will work together to find peaceful means on how to deal with incidents in this strategic waterway. So we are still waiting on the new mechanisms, as mentioned earlier, on how the Philippines and Vietnam would actually face the growing threat of China in these waters. Now, Carmina, aside from this memorandum of agreement with regard to the South China Sea, the two countries has also inked deals on agriculture as well as maritime or Coast Guard cooperation. The Vietnamese Prime Minister last year mentioned that these agricultural agreements may have something to do with a five-year rice supply deal between the two countries, especially during times of crisis. So far, Carmina, the president is still having a meeting with various Vietnamese leaders, and during lunchtime, he is expected to proceed here at the hotel in Hanoi to meet more Vietnamese officials as well as business leaders. Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Katrina Domingo. They are joining us live from Hanoi in Vietnam. And